So declining balance method, okay, again, so let's see the function. So the cost you have to provide, okay, salvage you have to provide, life you have to provide. The period in which the depreciation is done, that you have to provide. Okay, there's one more item here. Okay, this is a month. Okay, so what is this month? Okay, so month is the number of months in the first year. Okay, now see this. Suppose you have our financial year starts from April to March, right? Now you are not going to buy all your machine in April. So some of the machines you will buy in, let's say, September, some of them you buy in December, right? So when you are computing the depreciation, okay, whether you should depreciate for the entire year or whether you should depreciate for half of the year or 3 months, that is your choice. Okay. However, government has some restriction. Okay. So in India, the rule is this: if you buy the machine in the first half of the financial year, you can depreciate it for the full year. If you buy it in the second half of the financial year, you have to depreciate only by half. So even if you are buying the machine on 31st March, you can depreciate it by half, right? So this month you have to provide, okay? But if you don't provide anything, it is assumed to be 12. If you are depreciating only half, you have to put 6, okay? But this is valid only for the first year. After that, it is the full depreciation that is being done, okay? Right? So this DB, as of now, I have omitted. We are in this course, we are only worried about the full depreciation. So in year one, we have depreciated it fully. So you see that this declining balance, it is more than the sum of year digit. Okay. Yeah, here actually I have done this sum of year digit 6. Okay. So you can see this. When we do 6, it is exactly by half. Okay. So it is only for the first month you should be. A first year you should be worried. Here I have done, but I would say only for the first year. And so anyway, we are not covering this. I have written, but I am not covering. We are saying this is you have. Okay. Okay. So next year you have this. You drag it down. You have this as a depreciation. So see, out of 5,000, the first 2 years you are depreciated 2,700 in the declining balance. So it is much better method, okay, than sum of year digit method. It is more aggressive depreciation is better for the company. Okay, more aggressive means more accelerated. This is less accelerated. It is bad for the company. Okay, so the company which is falling. Okay, so I have one quick question. Okay, which will show more profit in the initial years? A straight line company will show more profit after tax. That is what Sandeep had asked. Profit after tax. A company which follows straight line will show more profit after tax, or a company which follows declining balance will show more profit after tax? So which one will have more profit after tax? Okay, for this, let's see, we do a simple calculation. We take a simple company, okay, assuming its revenue is, okay, so let's say its revenue is 10,000 rupees and there is no other cost, only depreciation cost is there. As per the straight line, what is the depreciation first year? 490. Okay, so second year also it will be 490, assuming revenue remains constant. So 1 year, 2 year, 3 year revenue is constant. Okay, so what is the profit before tax? So profit before tax is 10,000. Sorry, profit before tax is G6 minus G7. Okay. Okay. So this is the profit after profit before tax. Just 1 minute. Okay, so what will happen is profit before tax is this, and then let's say tax rate is 25%, assuming. Okay, so how much is the tax we are paying, and what is the PAT? So this company shows higher profit. Okay, this we can compute. Okay, so this is a straight line, all the years are same. If you are doing this accelerated depreciation method, okay, what will happen? We have depreciation. First year is how much? First year is 1620. Second year is 1095. Okay. So the rest can be done from here. So see, if a company follows PBT we did give, no? Okay, we have to take the PBT. Okay. Yeah. See, if the companies follow straight line, it will show a profit of 7132. If a company follows the declining balance, it has a lower profit. Okay. So most of the management, if they are worried about showing higher profit to the shareholders, they will go with straight line method. Okay. They will not follow this method. However, I'll tell you that this is a better method because from the cash point of view. Okay. So if you compute the cash, okay, with the company, assuming revenue is full cash received, no receivables. Okay. And tax is cash paid. So cash received is how much? 7622. Okay. This is the operating cash. Okay. What is operating cash here? First year received revenue, all cash. Minus tax paid. So see, 7905. This is 7622. So which is better? So profit wise, this is bad. Cash wise, this is better. Right? So a prudent management will go for a accelerated depreciation method. Okay. But there are some other fundas, okay, which we'll see maybe in the other courses. Okay. But as of now, this is the idea. So declining balance has higher depreciation in the initial years as compared to the straight line. But after that, see, it falls. So total depreciation, if you compute it the same, see, this is 4900. Sum of year digit also full is 4900. Double declining balance, declining balance is also 4900. In declining balance, 6 month depreciation in the first year. Okay. So this is 810. Okay. If you have, okay. By the way, this Excel does it internally. Okay. So if you have done this six in the first month, first year, you have to select this six in the later years. So internally, Excel will adjust the calculation. So you see that at the end, it is not covering the full. So in the 6 month depreciation, if you have done, it comes only 4876. Okay. We'll consider this later. What is happening? Because the time frame is not enough, okay, for the company to cover the entire depreciation. Okay, right. So if I extend this 11th year, it has covered. So the idea is this: since the first year you have depreciated only 6 months, you go 11th year, you depreciate 6 months there, and approximately you will get the same amount. That is the idea. Okay, right. So that's why this is slightly tricky, but as of now, we'll leave it. We'll don't go for the 11th year deposition. Okay?